Dennis, you've just been watching the highlights of your performance back. What do you make of the destruction that you've just put forth in, to move to 4-0?
Yeah, I'm very happy. I thought the ball very, very well. I set up an opponent as well, who stopped a few prospects that kid has. I'm only taking it step by step. I'm only young, I'm only 18 years of age. I'm a trainer, Al Smith, Eddie Lamb, Paul Taylor, Adam Hart, who's in the corner as well, and MTK, so I thank them, isn't it? They just take me step by step, and also from all of Frank Warren, the best in the business.
Frank Warren just walked past me as you were coming down to conduct this post-fight interview, and he pulled me aside and said, I've said it to you before, but I'll say it again, that you remind him of a young Nazim Hamed. What does it make you feel when you hear yourself mentioned in the same breath as a legendary Sheffield fighter?
Oh, I feel on top of the world. I feel like I'm buzzing right now, to be honest. I'm so happy. But it's got to, I'm only young, as I said already. I want to take it step by step. I'm coming for all the big boys. I'm coming from. Remember that. Dennis McCann's coming from.
Alan said that his gym is normally known for tippy-tap, clever textbook boxers, but you seem to rip the textbook up. You show your fundamentals, but a lead uppercut, lead hooks, whipping shots to the body like that. Where does this flash and flamboyance that you possess come from?
Dennis the Menace, that's my name, isn't it? Dennis the Menace. I just want to thank all my sponsors as well, also MTK Global, Crown's Kitchens, Rankins, Well Hydrate, and Donado, best girls in the business. I want to thank them all. That's all I've
got
to say.
Well, listen, congratulations on the performance. Very well done in improving to 4-0 with 3 stoppages as well. Very well done indeed.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I suppose he might have been the baby-faced assassin had somebody not got there first. David, what do you think of it all?
I love it. I really do. Nazim Hamed was one of my favourite fighters of all time growing up as a teenager. And this Dennis the Menace, he actually punches, he appears to punch harder than Naz did at this stage in his career. When Naz, well, it took after about 8 fights did he really start settling in, sitting down on his shots. He used to throw clusters of punches. He didn't seem to have single punch power like Dennis the Menace does earlier in his career. For me, you can't teach what he does. The way he comes into range, the way he steps to the side, you can try and teach a kid that. You need ultimate confidence in your timing and reflexes to know that you're not going to get countered. You know, Dennis, for me, you know, he has everything you could possibly want in a bantamweight. The punch power was ridiculous for someone of his size.
He always seems to have time, but somewhere along the line, and I always go back to the best example, was seeing the battle of levels in this ring a long, long time ago when Barrera came to these shores. I'll never forget it. The top guys are clever, David, you know that, in any weight division. Yep. So what are the tests that they need to give him so that he's ready to start to move forward?
As he said, he was fighting a very experienced fighter there. For an 18-year-old, he's only had 3 professional contests, now 4. So 3 of those by stoppage. He needs to stay around this level for 3 or 4 more fights just to feel it out, just to get different styles, maybe fight a southpaw. There's no rush. He's 18 years of age. He needs to take his time and just gradually work through the rankings. Like, looking at him there, he looks absolutely fantastic. Whatever he's doing in the gym, you know, Eddie Lamb, you know, Alan, you know, Alan Smith, they know what they're doing. These guys are particularly at his weight level, his weight category. You know, he's got a seasoned team in the corner who know the right steps to take at the right time.